Did you know Sego had achieved only 1% of its target sales in 6 years since its launch? Isn't that terrible? But definitely there's a lesson to be learned here. Stay tuned till the end to find out. Hey there, welcome to 9th episode of our real series on 10 dysfunctions of product management. In this episode, we are diving into the bridge to nowhere. You see, product teams love to build solutions for the problems. But sometimes they take it tad too far and build for the problems that are yet to appear on the horizon. They start over-engineering the products, trying to account for every possible future needs, even if those needs are unlikely ever to materialize. This is what we call the bridge to nowhere. The Segway is a textbook example for the bridge to nowhere dysfunction. This personal transportation device was invented by Dean Kamen in 1999 and was revealed to the world on Good Morning America show. Upon its release, Kamen believed that Segway will do to walking what calculator did to pad and pencil. You'll get there quicker. The company Segway also had tremendous funding and resources. The level of press and TV exposure was astounding. Then why did Segway fail? Let us look at the reasons. Number one was over-engineering. The Segway was loaded with too much technology, increasing the price to $5,000. It also weighed over 50 kgs when it was launched, so it didn't make much sense to buy or use this machine. Number two is that Segway was a solution in search of a problem. It was not a clear improvement in the existing transportation options such as bicycles and scooters. So even though many people wanted to buy one, they didn't have a reason to buy it. Number three is infrastructure and regulation issues. Most cities are designed for pedestrians and large vehicles, but nothing in between. So there was no infrastructure to support the Segway as a form of mass transportation. In many countries, it was banned from sidewalks and roads because authorities didn't know how to classify it. The fourth reason is complexity and safety issues. The Segway was way too complicated and unsafe. It required a lot of skill and balance to operate, making it difficult for beginners and elderly people. It also had high risk of accidents and injuries, especially when riding in uneven surfaces or in crowded areas. The fifth is lack of target market clarity. Segway was marketed as a transportation device for everyone, but it was not clear who would actually use it. The early adopters of Segway were also called as fat and lazy, which impacted sales and public perception. The last and final nail in the coffin for Segway was competition. In 2017, electric scooter companies such as Bird and Lime effectively sealed the fate of the Segway. These scooters, controlled by an app, were a much cheaper and safer form of personal transportation in cities. In 2015, Segway was acquired by Ninebot, a Chinese company that makes electric scooters and other personal transportation devices. Ninebot tried to revive Segway, but it was not successful, and it was eventually discontinued in 2020. The Segway gives important lesson to product leaders. Products that are not solving a real problem or a current market need are likely to fail. That's it for this episode. If you enjoyed this reel, please follow our page for more insights on products. Stay tuned for next episode with another dysfunction. Thank you for watching.